just for you, love, and it can be
just ain't enough love.
Just ain't enough love.
She said, Yeah. got.
She's smiling. Houston took a lead with 5.5 minutes left. It was a 2-point lead. The score was 54-52. And since then, LA has gone on a 12-0 run. Well, if this isn't physical enough for you, the X Games are coming up next from Philadelphia. Stick around for that. 2:42 to go. Doris, you mentioned it. An extraordinarily important game for LA. I would stand by this. Most important game in franchise history.
There's no doubt. This Houston team is a very proud franchise. But Michael Mobley stated at the start of the year, the championship should run through LA. You know, one of the players you talked about to us was Yukari Figgs. At her maturation during the latter part of the season. Well, Figgs, 11 points, 9 assists. There she is. The point guard, in my estimation, is the single most important position on the floor in the game of basketball at whatever level you have it. Decision making. The ball's in her hands so much. 10 of Lisa Leslie's points have come from the foul line. She's 10 of 12. 66-54. Sparks enjoying a comfortable lead, but they know better than to get comfortable. Well, you got to come with all-out pressure and make some things happen defensively. But what this does do, Doris, is sets up an anticipated matchup between Yolanda Griffith and Lisa Leslie. Should that come to pass?
Wow, what a spectacular matchup that will be.
Mabika, just off the mark from three. Some question, but this ball is going to Houston, and Tammy Jackson is coming back on the floor. It seems to me that Houston was defending LA better with Jackson on the floor.
Yes. And she was making some things happen on the offensive end as well. Drew a couple of fouls against Lisa Leslie. But you're right, what a matchup. If LA is able to hold this 10-point lead between Yolanda Griffith and Lisa Leslie, both have raised their level of play in the postseason. Griffith has been nothing short of phenomenal, and Lisa Leslie has been Lisa Leslie. Stafford Odom. And a rebound by Stafford Odom. And now a foul called against Los Angeles. Delisha Milton said, not me, and she said, not Mabika either. You got some phenomenal athletes on Los Angeles. Stafford Odom goes up, and Mabika gives some assistance, and that's the fourth foul on Mabika. Stafford Odom, the 30-year-old rookie, played in the ABL, a two-time first-team All-Pac-10 player. A chance at the line. 1:34 to go. A timeout here in Los Angeles. 10-point LA lead. Cheryl swoops down at the dumps because Tina Thompson is in the locker room injured.
Some might see it as a pile of rocks, but it's really
sweet. Why don't you go get a drink?
Okay. Good idea.
Imported hops give Michelob Light a smooth, satisfying taste you won't find in an ordinary beer.
So organic.
It makes me feel so insignificant.
Tell me about Man with Michelob Light.
Beer or Michelob Light?
Oh, there you are.
Ma'am, please don't touch the art.
A
Are you open?
Open to the new spirit of hair color. Introducing Open, the first soft permanent color gel by L'Oreal, with low ammonia and botanical conditioners for soft touch hair. Get Open, vibrantly natural color gel by L'Oreal Paris.
Yeah, I'm the ultimate competitor. Go G-O-A-T, et cetera, light years ahead of ya. They chose me instead of ya. Corny cats is better to give praise to the greatest. Silence all challenges. LL ambidextrous, switch the left hand on ya. Leave it on the floor, pure, raw stamina. I said my game's hardcore.
Leave it on the floor.
I said my game's hardcore.
Leave it on the floor.
Do you, Yahoo?
Are you open?
Open to the new spirit of hair color. Introducing Open, the first soft permanent color gel by L'Oreal, with low ammonia and botanical conditioners for soft touch hair. Get Open, vibrantly natural color gel by L'Oreal Paris.
Los Angeles up by 10, and tomorrow at 8 Eastern on ESPN, Game 3, Miami and New York, followed at 10 on ESPN by Game 3 of this series, if necessary, and don't sell Houston short. Then Friday, beginning at 7, the Game 1s of the Eastern and Western Conference Finals. Houston has one last gasp. No one believes that more than head coach Van Chancellor.
Hey, guys, we have fought too long not to fight right now. All we need is a 2 free throws and a 3 ball or 2.
Van Chancellor, ever the optimist, a 3 ball or 2. They are 3 of 16 from behind the arc tonight, but we have seen Houston with miracle finishes before, and yes, they're without Cynthia Cooper. They're without Cheryl Swoops, and tragically right now, they're without Tina Thompson.
As you mentioned, they've never lost 3 straight. That is at stake as well. You're left wondering what it would have been like with Tina on the floor, as you're left wondering what the series would have been like with a healthy Cheryl Swoops.
No question. And it is worth remembering that Cheryl Swoops is already up and about, recovering well from her injury. She comes back next season alongside a healthy Tina Thompson and Jeanette Arcane. You see an improving rookie in Amanda Lassiter, not to mention Tricia Stafford Odom. Houston can grab the championship right back should they lose it here.
Think about this. Amanda Lassiter and Tricia Stafford Odom and all those players got an awful lot of experience because of the injury to Swoops.
X Games coming up next. Van Chancellor just a moment ago having some fun with the fans. A minute 32 to play as Nikki McCrimmon extends the lead 67-58. Tammy Jackson well off the mark there, just launched them. But Houston's bench, 1 of 11 from the floor, and Mawadi Mabika may have iced it right there. 7 points for Mabika.
Well, it's been transition during the latter stages of this game that separated Los Angeles, so how appropriate that they pad it here, doing exactly that. The 2-on-1, Mawadi Mabika in the open floor. Very nice finish.
Tammy Jackson called for her 4th foul.
That push they made where they got several transition buckets. Mawadi's jumper, Figs, the completion in a 3-point play. That was where it turned.
Completes it, and getting ready to check into the game for Houston is Yelena Shakirova. Sparks with their largest lead, an even dozen. Houston is in desperation mode right now. Coquise Washington turns it over. As Shakirova comes in for the Comets,
Petrana Gergen-Fonseca comes in for L.A. And the Buick player of the game is no shock. Lisa Leslie, 28 and 18. Those 18 rebounds, a career playoff high. And Buick will donate $1,000 to the Make-A-Wish Foundation on behalf of Lisa Leslie. Buick, it's all good. Yolanda versus Lisa. One MVP, Yolanda, and shortly to be named Lisa. They're going to go head-to-head in the Western Conference Finals. What a superior matchup. It's more than intriguing. If these two keep playing the way they've been playing, Doris, that'll be one for the ages. She carried Los Angeles for periods tonight, Lisa. Still looking all business with 37.9 ticks left in this game and a 12-point lead. No celebrating on that LA bench yet. Tynesha Lewis. Houston has had perhaps a bigger heart this season than in any of the four previous seasons. Van Chancellor has perhaps done his best job of coaching. They came in with a number four seed. And the turning point of this game was Tina Thompson going down with an injury with about 11 minutes to play in the game. And right now, Mawadi Mabika tosses the ball in the air. And they will move on to face Sacramento, who also swept. Charlotte has advanced in the East with a big upset tonight over the top seed Cleveland. Miami and New York will settle it tomorrow night at 8 Eastern on ESPN. Leah B. Olson. Let's hear from her now. Go ahead, Leah.
Lisa, just tell us what you're feeling after all these years finally taking out the Comets.
Well, it definitely feels good, but that's just one game. We got four more to go, and we feel really good. We wanted to come back home. We played well. We had a little slump in there when we didn't score, so we'll look at that game, and we'll get ready to play Sacramento. We feel real good about our matchup, and we're looking forward to going there.
Unfortunate to see Tina Thompson go down in this game.
Definitely. I hope that she's not seriously injured or that her knees aren't hurt. I heard she had cramping. So, I mean, you know, that's a better injury to have other than, you know, having her knee go out or anything like that. I have lots of love for Tina, obviously, and I'll be calling her, asking her for some advice about going on to the next round.
Lisa, we look forward to seeing you in Sacramento and the matchup with you and Yolanda Griffin.
Definitely. Looking forward to it.
All right. Michelle, we'll take you back.
No one better to get advice from, Lisa, than Tina Thompson. Our final score, L.A. 70, Houston 58. L.A. takes the series 2-0. WNBA playoff coverage continues tomorrow on ESPN at 8 Eastern with Game 3 of Miami and New York. The X Games are coming up next. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Don't forget, we'll see you tomorrow from Miami in New York. So long from L.A.
What's the deal, Philadelphia? Welcome to day 3 of the X Games. The only place you need to be is right here. Sal Mazzucchelli here with you. I'm standing on the vert ramp. This is the largest crowd in the history of the X Games, and we're losing our minds. Right now, we're talking about vert doubles, and I want you to meet somebody, Mr. Tony Hawk. Say hi to Philly, Tony.
Hello, Philadelphia.
This energy is like nothing we ever seen before at the X Games, crowd-wise. You have so many things that you're doing, whether it be your game or the Tony Hawk tour. Why do you decide to compete in doubles every year at the X Games?
It's fun. It's like it's a whole new level of creativity. I just like seeing what we can come up with, and it's just a blast, you know? I mean, not as much pressure as a normal contest, and just more spontaneous, like, just really creative.
Your team member is Annie McDonald. What's the name of your team?
Well, we chose YMCA since we both practice at YMCA.
All right, let's hear it for Tony Hawk and Team YMCA. Vert Doubles, let's do this!
The name, Hawk, McDonald. The game, skateboard doubles.
Calling all straight, man.
Skateboard doubles, next.
We're about to have so much fun here at the Vert Doubles Final. Chris Miller, we've got Team Don't Mess with the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Mike Crum and Chris Gentry skating first. And what is it about Vert Doubles that that makes it so much fun?
Well, doubles is it's kind of, these guys only get to do this really once a year. It happens at the X Games. Whoa. But it's an opportunity for them to really just go on out there and kind of put on a show and have some fun with it, do some combinations. It really is fun to skate doubles. And it is challenging. Obviously, you're kind of creating more opportunity for mishap
these
by
guys
adding
are
another.
Ripping right now.
Definitely. Mike Crum just going all over the place underneath Gentry's 540s, just ripping up. You can see from his face, he's a happy camper right there. These guys are having a good time. Take another look at this. Here, Gentry goes up, does a big melon 540 over Crum's backside 50-50. You have to get a lot of height to clear the other guy. And here, Crum coming up and chasing Gentry on that frontside rodeo 5.
The Chainsaw Massacre duo is with the Aussie Gangster.
Okay, you guys from the same town, is that right?
Same state.
Yeah. Has that got anything to do with you guys skating together?
Yeah, we grew up skating together since we were like 12.
Were you nervous at all there, Crum?
Yeah, I was tripping.
I saw you trembling on that axle stall. Explain that axle stall for me.
I don't know. The crowd, when they announced me, it freaked me out. It made me start thinking how many people
were. So it's the crowd's fault?
Yeah, it's the crowd.
All right, you're going to go up. And is there any more moves that are going to come out in the next one?
We got a secret move.
Yeah. Secret move?
Yeah, we got a line locked in there.
Great program, so in the very near future, you'll be hearing about some more of those programs, and we're going to be involved in each one of those programs. So we'd like to thank each and every one once again for joining us tonight here at Southfield High School. Give yourselves a fine round of applause. Sometimes pretend to be your friend. But guess what? You asked for them, and we got them. If you will, everybody in Southfield High School tonight, put your hands together collectively. Let's bring some love over the building tonight. Let's give it up for the undisputed. How about it for the undisputed truth?